Good morning, students. Good morning. Please stand up. At least pay some respect. Stand up, please. Good morning. Stand up, everyone. Please stand up. You can stand up. Please. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. Sit down, sit down, sit down. So today, we are going to study about maths, and our equation that we are going to prove today is x plus y whole square equal to x square plus y square plus 2xy. So we are going to say how LHS will be equal to RHS. Hey, Tony, where are you? Please, everyone, look at Tony. He is lost in his own world, own fantasy world, must be thinking something. Yeah? Might be he must be thinking that after this period gets over, Sangeeta ma'am is going to come and take the history class. Or might be he is thinking that when the period will get over and when the lunch period will come and when he is going to take the lunch of Rahul. Or might be he is thinking that after the school gets over, how he is going to propose his girlfriend. Don't laugh. Don't laugh. Okay. Let's change the topic for the day. And, okay. And move the topic to F A N T S Y. Fantasy. Okay? You know what? What is the problem with this current generation? They think a lot about the past, which they can't change. They think a lot about the future, which they again can't change. But they don't think about the present because they don't want to change, because they don't like challenges. So, let me give you a small story, okay? Listen to it very carefully. And Tony, especially you, this is for you, okay? So, there was a man who was walking onto the streets. He was a poor man. Along with him, a small student, say 4 or 5 year old, he was a child, he was also walking along with him. After walking to some distance, these men saw that there were around 4 or 5 small child who were finding something on the mud. The man really got excited. The man went to that mud and asked those students, what you guys are finding? One of the child said that we are finding that gold clock which is there in the mud. The man got really excited. He went into his own fancy world. He started thinking a lot. He started thinking that once I get this gold clock, my entire future is going to change. My child's future is going to change. He will be earning millions. He will be getting his own job. He'll be having his own house. He'll be having his own swimming pool. He'll be having everything of his own. So without thinking anything, he said to his child that go to that mud and get that clock. The child, obeying his father's order, he went into that mud and started finding that clock. After finding for some time, there's a big pothole which was just beside to that mud. The boy started getting drowned in that mud. The man thought that it must be a normal thing. The boy started shouting that I am getting drowned, please help me. But the father said that no, don't make excuses. There are other 4 or 5 students who are already finding that clock. Why can't you get it? The boy continuously find it, but he could not find it, and ultimately he was drowned and he lost his life. The man could not believe what happened. He was trying to get that clock just for the betterment of his future. But because he went into his own fancy world, he could not think anything. He started crying. He started shouting. For 2 hours or so, he was sitting there. Some of the students who were finding those clocks, they went off because they could not get the clock. Then there was this monk that was passing through that road. The monk saw this guy. This monk saw this guy and came to this guy and said to him, what happened, my son? This man said that he said the entire story to this monk. The monk saw that mud and he saw that man and he started smiling. He said to that man, what has happened? If you would not have gone to your own fancy world, if you would have applied your own conscience mind, if you would have been more careful, you would not have sent your child to that mud. that clock is not onto the mud, but that is onto the tree, and the shadow is falling onto the mud. If you would have applied the brain, you could have saved your child. The man could not believe what happened. He was still crying, and he sat down. So what lesson have you learned, student, from this? That don't ever go to the fantasy world. Stay in present, do the right thing, and let the future be what it is. Got it, Tony? Yeah? Good. So let me break one more fantasy for you. Next period, Sangeeta ma'am is not going to come. I'm going to take the class. Okay? So let's again change the topic and move back to x plus y whole square equal to x square plus yx plus 2xy.